Syracuse is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go.
He sends this one deep.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 42. Just throws this one away.
Solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Hey, number eight's coming. Number
dog,
eight's
four. X, seven. Motion.
He gets out to about the 48-yard line. First down pick up by the tailback.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
Picked off.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 48. Fires quick. He's got another one. Tackle made at the 42-yard line.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
From the 28-yard line, it's first down. Runs outside for a nice game. This is the ninth play of this drive. Knocked out of bounds at the 13. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Go four.
And he's tackled at the 4. Here's the 11th play of the drive.
Black five.
And he throws it away. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. The stop at the 2-yard line. And this is the 13th play of this drive. Brought down at the 1.
That brings him second and goal.
From the 1-yard line, second down. This defense not wanting to give an inch here.
Go.
Touchdown, UConn!
That is great tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
makes the PAT. It was a 14-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook try. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 7-0. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Syracuse, a team and a program that year in, year out, has got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two. And they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that in front of them.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
To his tight end, nothing doing. From their own 25-yard line, third down. And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Four down. Hey, check.
Second down and 10 to go.
Ready.
Ball on the 36. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. The defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Gets to about the 34-yard line.
The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
And he's taken down to the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. Connecticut is up a score. Makes it out to about the 43. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. Booming kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Tackle at the 28-yard line. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. 7-0, UConn. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. They'll bring him down at about the 29-yard line. Fire, fire, fire. there before he stepped out of bounds.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. That makes it first and ten. Quick pass. He goes out of bounds at the 38. So it's another third down upcoming here. He's out of bounds at the 38-yard line. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
Kicks up. The upright and through. We got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Connecticut holds a 4-point lead. He's tackled right around the 40.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
From their own 40-yard line. First down. Nice catch. First down, and he's knocked out. He makes it to the 48-yard line. Second and nine. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
Hey, kill, kill, kill!
And he almost has the INT.
Number nine breaks up the pass. That'll make it third and nine.
On the ground, picked up by the defense.
What was most impressive is how he followed the play and he just didn't give up on it. It was that effort that allowed him to come away with the fumble.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Hand off on the counter. Tackled after decent pickup.
That makes it second and six.
Gets out to around the 38.
First down.
takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Gives it to the back. He fights forward to about the 26. Five wide. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 23-yard line. Third down now. They need to get it to the 17.
Here we go. Green 9, huh?
Zips it to the tight end. They get only a yard from the pass play.
Well, it's a good job here to just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start, offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. The kick is up, and it's good.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
7-6, UConn. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Connecticut is up one. He's hit right away. 3, maybe 4 yards on the pass.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
Tackle made at the 39. From their own 39-yard line. First down. Bounds at the 41. A couple of yards there.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
Makes a catch and he's got nowhere to go. From the 41-yard line, it's first down. He's taken down at about the 35. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
He's tackled at the 29. So they gain 6 yards on the play and pick up the first down.
Heads up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. Caught with room to work. Steps out of bounds at the 13-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. Connecticut with a 1-point lead.
Back five, back five. X.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
Easy, easy. Where? Where?
fake and looking to run. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. They weren't able to defend the quarterback scramble, and they give up six.
And he's one of those quarterbacks who can do this when he's close to the goal line. He'll pump fake, then take off, or he'll put his head down and crash it in. Anything goes with this guy.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one.
Syracuse coaching staff, I've got to think going into halftime, and we're getting close right now, Kirk. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running back's just not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff and a quarterback on offense is tested. Their star player is not having a great game, losing this football game. I think now as we're close to this half, now is when we start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack to be able to put points up.
It's second and five here. Ball on the 30. He heaves it deep.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Going deep. Makes the grab and he's knocked out of bounds. Big play right there. First down. The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he nails the long field goal. So at the end of the half, UConn leads it 14-9.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here completely locked in on that first half. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got her back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, it's great too, is you build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a 5-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games. And you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to your opponent's territory.
Can't tack on any yardage. That reception good for 7 yards.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. Steps out around the 33-yard line.
gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Brought down at the 34-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Got a man in and out of his hands.
Number four was the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. It's the junior, and he's finally shoved out at the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line, first down. After a nice pickup.
That makes it second and six.
And down he goes, around the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, first down. Taken down around the 29-yard line.
Boy, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Gives it left side, and they make the stop at the 27.
Call it a gain of 2 yards.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. They bring him down.
Brett, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
Fourth and long here after the sack. It has the distance, and he just drilled it from long range. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Wide open, incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Here we go! Line 80!
Throws complete. He's hammered.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it 3-3.
Let's go!
Fires out to his wideout. They'll bring him down at about the 49.
Gain of 17 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Check mic 33. Check mic 33. Ready.
Brought down the 39-yard line.
Gain of 12 yards. First down.
Four down.
Mic 6, 33.
33. Here we go.
Decent run here, right side.
Makes the tackle. second and three.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
And here's another third down. He's scrambling. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown.
What made this so impressive was first his ability to see where the space was to run, and then the athletic ability to get it into the end zone.
They need to tie it up here, and that's exactly why they're going for two.
Hey, check Mike 33. Check Mike 33.
Here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
End zone picked off. They don't get it. So a 9-play, 75-yard drive. But they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Connecticut is up two. He's tackled at the 23-yard line.
Loss of two on the play.
From their own 23-yard line. Second down.
A nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Stop short.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Tackle made at the 33-yard line.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
He's got it out to his tight end, and he's hit immediately. One more quarter of action remaining, and this one has been a real treat. The Huskies in front by two. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. They come out on an empty backfield. And he got it to the sophomore. Tackle made at the 39.
Call it a gain of 13 yards. First down.
In the shotgun and five wideouts.
Ready, check.
Completes it across the middle. And now the ball is loose. The defense scoops it. That was a huge turnover.
And it couldn't have come at a better time for this defense. You're trying to come up with a big stop, and now you get the ball back with the lead.
Quick
question now in a one-possession game. Can they make it a two-possession game? They've got a chance to put this thing out of reach.
Connecticut holds just a two-point lead. The halfback picks up a yard.
That was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Out to about the 44-yard line. From their own 44-yard line, it's second down.
Red, two, green, go!
Get to that quickly. He's taken down around the 48-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
Tight left, tight left. Four down.
Hey, check Mike 11, check Mike 11.
Don't. Easy.
He's tackled at about the 37-yard line.
Everybody was fooled on that play.
Hey, that was a good job here by the quarterback. That could have play fake as a real weapon against an aggressive defense like this.
From the 37-yard line, it's first down.
He's got an opening. He's at the 20.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
With a two-point advantage.
Here we go. X7. Easy. Blue 20. Go.
Fights forward to about the 13.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 13.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 11. Check Mike 11. Red 2. Blue 20.
Are the kind of hits that'll take some miles off a ball carrier.
They'll line it up again on third down. Play fake, looking to run. And down he goes, around the 7-yard line. The quarterback trying to make a play.
Well, he did a nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big hits.
It's up, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Syracuse staff right now has got to be thinking what the defense is looking at and what they're going to be keying on.
Well, the defense is going to be looking at this running back. They're going to put everybody that they can to be able to stop him and not allow him to make a big play. That means the offense is going to have to be able to find somebody else maybe on this drive ready to step up and maybe become the hero and be able to win this game.
Quick strike to the back, no good.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith in your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Just under 2 minutes in the game.
Bring him down for a sack on the play. So the sack makes this third and very long.
Man left, man left. Four down. 117.
Ready. 168.
Throws it to the outside. It fly. Missed him.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield.
This defensive end just showed us why he's much more than just a pass rusher.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 17. They'll keep it on the ground again. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. We have less than a minute to go. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The defense forced a turnover on downs on the last drive.
Hey, Brad, remember the last time this offense came out of the field? Of course, they went for it on fourth down. Sometimes it drives me crazy when we call all these games and these guys out here go for it all the time on fourth down. Here's a message. If it's longer than fourth and five, just consider a field goal or a punt. 14 yards.
First down. And he's immediately tackled.
Hammerhead. Here we go. Green 90.
And he's taken down at the 37-yard line.
White 80.
The spike will stop the clock.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37.
Mike check, 33.
Fires out to his receiver. He's hit and taken down. Spikes the ball.
That'll bring up fourth and five.
Tight end right.
So they'll have one last shot here to possibly tie this game up. They'll need their prayers to be answered if they don't want to lose this one. Throws it deep. So the big blow comes from the defense. They come up with the stop of the day, and that'll ice this football game. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Connecticut holds an 8-point advantage. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. And that that should do it. Our final tally in this one. Connecticut 23, Syracuse 15.
Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
Yeah, this was a great football game played by two teams that really wanted to win. Syracuse made a few more mistakes in this game than their opponents. Whether it's turnovers, penalties, missed tackles, or blown assignments, you just can't afford to make mistakes and expect to win.
EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.